It was the worthy Lord of Lorn. He was a lord of a high degree. He had no more children but one son. He set him to school to learn courtesy. Learning did so proceed with that child, I tell you all in verity. He learned more upon one day than other children did on three. And then bespake the schoolmaster unto the Lord of Lorn, said he, I think thou be some stranger born, for the Holy Ghost remains with thee. He said, I am no stranger born, forsooth, master, I tell it to thee. It is a gift of Almighty God, which he hath given unto me. The schoolmaster turned him round about, his angry mind he thought to assuage, for the child could answer him so quickly, and was of so tender a year of age. The child he caused a steed to be brought, a golden bridle done him upon. He took his leave of his schoolfellows, and home the child that he is gone. And when he came before his father, he fell low down upon his knee. My blessing, father, I would ask, if Christ would grant you would give it me. Now God thee bless, my son and my heir, his servant in heaven that thou may be. What tidings hast thou brought me, child? Thou art come home so soon to me. Good tidings, father, I have you brought. Good tidings, I hope it is to thee. The book is not in old Scotland, but I can read it before your ear. A joyful man his father was, even the worthy Lord of Lorn. Thou shalt go into France, my child, the speeches of all strange lands to learn. But then bespake the child his mother, the Lady of Lorn, and then was she. Says, who must be his well good guide when he goes into that strange country? And then bespake that bonny child unto his father tenderly. Says, father, I'll have the hen steward, for he hath been true to you and me. The lady to counsel the steward did take, and counted down £100 there. Says, steward, be true to my son and my heir, and I will give thee mickle mare. If I be not true to my master, he said, Christ himself be not true to me. If I be not true to my lord and master, an ill death then that I may die. The Lord of Lorn did apparel his child with brooch and ring and many a thing. The apparel he had his body upon, they say, was worth a squire's living. The parting of the young Lord of Lorn with his father, his mother, his fellows dear, would have made a man's heart for to change if a Jew born that he were. The wind did serve and they did sail over the sea into France land. He used the child so hardly, he would let him have never a penny to spend. And meat he would let the child have none, nor money to buy none truly. The boy was hungry and thirsty both, alas, it was the more pity. He laid him down to drink the water that was so low beneath the brim. He that was wont to drink ale and wine, then was fain of the water so thin. And as he was drinking of the water that ran so low beneath the brim, so ready was the false steward to drown the bonny boy therein. Have mercy on me, worthy steward, my life, he said, lend it to me, and all that I am heir upon, says I, will give unto thee. Mercy to him the steward did take, and pulled the child out of the brim. Ever alack, the more pity, he took his clothes even from him. Says, do thou me off that velvet gown, the crimson hose beneath thy knee, and do me off thy cornivan shoon, are buckled with the gold so free. Do thou me off thy satin doublet, thy shirt band wrought with glistering gold, and do me off thy golden chain about thy neck so many a fold. Do thou me off thy velvet hat with feather in that is so fine, all unto thy silken shirt that's wrought with many a golden seam. The child before him naked stood, with skin as white as lily flower. For this worthy lord's beauty, he might have been a lady's paramour. He put upon him a leather coat, and breeches of the same beneath the knee, and sent that bonny child him fro, service for to crave truly. He pulled then forth a naked sword that hang full low then by his side. Turn thy name, thou villain, he said, or else this sword shall be thy guide. What must be my name, worthy steward? I pray thee now tell it to me. Thy name shall be poor disaware, to tend sheep on a lonely knee. The bonny child he went him fro, and looked to himself truly. Saw his apparel so simple upon, O Lord, he weeped tenderly. Unto a shepherd's house the child did go, and said, Sir God, you save and see. Do you not want a servant boy to tend your sheep on a lonely lea? Where wast thou born? The shepherd said, Where, my boy, or in what country? Sir, he said, I was born in fair Scotland, that is so far beyond the sea. I have no child, the shepherd said, my boy, thou'st tarry and dwell with me. My living, he said, and all my goods, I'll make thee heir of after me. Then bespake the shepherd's wife to the Lord of Lorn, thus did she say, Go thy way to our sheep, she said, and tend them well both night and day. It was a sore office, O Lord, for him that was a lord born of a high degree, as he was tending his sheep alone, neither sport nor play could he. let us leave talking of the Lord of Lorn, and let all such talking go. Let us talk more of the false steward that caused the child all this woe. He sold this Lord of Lorn's his clothes for £500 to his pay there, and bought himself a suit of apparel might well beseem a lord to wear. When he that gorgeous apparel bought, that did so finely his body upon, he laughed the bonny child to scorn that was the bonny Lord of Lorn. He laughed that bonny boy to scorn. Lord, pity it was to hear. I have heard them say, and so have you too, that a man may buy gold too dear. When that he had all that gorgeous apparel that did so finely his body upon, he went to woo the Duke of France's daughter and called himself the Lord of Lorn. The Duke of France heard tell of this, to his place that worthy lord came truly. He entertained him with red Rhenish wine, says, Lord of Lorn, thou art welcome to me. Then to supper that they were set, lords and ladies in their degree. The steward was set next the Duke of France, an unseemly sight it was to see. Then bespake the Duke of France unto the Lord of Lorn, said he there, says, Lord of Lorn, if thou marry my daughter, I'll mend thy living 500 a year. Then bespake that lady fair, answered her father so alone, that she would be his married wife if he would make her Lady of Lorn. Then hand in hand the steward her he took, and plight that lady his troth alone, that she should be his married wife, and he would make her the Lady of Lorn. The lady would see the roebuck run, and also for to hunt the doe, and with 100 lusty men the lady did a hunting go. The lady is a hunting God over lee and fell, that is so he. There was she ware of a shepherd's boy, tending sheep on a lonely lee. And ever he sighed and made moan, and cried out so pitifully, my father is the Lord of Lorn, and knows not what's become of me. And then bespake the lady gay, and to her maid she spake anon, says, fetch me hither yon shepherd's boy, I'll know why he maketh all this moan. When he came before that lady fair, he fell down upon his knee. He had been so well brought up, he needed not to learn courtesy. Where wast thou born, thou bonny boy? Where or in what country? Madam, I was born in fair Scotland, that is so far beyond the sea. What is thy name, thou bonny boy? I pray thee tell it unto me. My name, he says, is poor Disaware, that tends the sheep on a lonely lee. One thing thou must tell me, bonny boy, which I must needs to ask of thee. dost thou not know the young Lord of Lorn? He has come a-wooing into France to me. Yes, that I do, madame, he said, and then he wept most tenderly. The Lord of Lorn is a worthy lord, if he were at home in his own country. What ails thee to weep, my bonny boy? Tell me, or ere I part thee fro. Nothing but for a friend, madame, that's dead from me many a year ago. A loud laughter the lady laughed, O Lord, she smiled wondrous he. I've dwelled in France since I was born, such a shepherd boy I did never see. Wilt thou not leave thy sheep, my child, and come into service unto me? And I will give thee meat and fee, and my chamberlain that thou shalt be. Then I will leave my sheep, madame, and come into service unto thee. If you will give me meat and fee, your chamberlain that I may be. When the lady come before her father, she fell low down upon her knee. Grant me, father, the lady said, this boy my chamberlain to be. But oh, nay, nay, the duke did say, so my daughter it may not be. The lord that is come a-wooing to you will be offended with you and me. When the steward looked on that bonny boy, an angry man, I wis, was he. Where was thou born, thou vagabond? Where, he said, and in what country? Says I was born in fair Scotland, that is so far beyond the sea. What is thy name, thou vagabond? Have done quickly and tell it to me. My name, he says, is poor disaware, I tend sheep on the lonely lea. Thou art a thief, the steward said, and so in the end I will prove thee. Then bespake the lady fair, peace, Lord of Lorn, I do pray thee. For if no love you show this child, no favour can you have of me. Will you believe me, lady fair, when the truth I do tell ye? At Aberdonny beyond the sea, his father he robbed 103. But then bespake the Duke of France unto the boy so tenderly. Says, boy, if thou love horses well, my stable groom I will make thee. Thus that did pass upon, till the 12 months did draw to an end. The boy applied his office so well, every man became his friend. He went forth early one morning, to water a gelding at the water so free. The gelding up and with his head, he hit the child above his ee. Woe be to thee, thou gelding, he said, and to the mare that foaled thee. Thou little knowest what thou hast done, thou hast stricken a lord of high degree. My father's the worthy Lord of Lorn, and child he hath no more but me. He sent me o'er the sea with the false steward, and thus that he hath beguiled me. The lady was in her garden green, she heard the child making great moan, and she ran to the weeping child and left her maidens all alone. Sing on thy song, thou stable groom, I will release thee of thy pain. I've made an oath, lady, he said, I dare not tell my tale again. Tell thy tale unto the horse, and then thou dost not sing to me. And when he told the horse his tale, the lady wept full tenderly. Woe be to the steward, he said, woe be to him verily. He hath been about this 12 months day for to deceive both thee and me. If you do not my counsel keep that I have told you with good intent, and if you do it not well keep, farewell, my life is at an end. I will be true to thee, Lord of Lorn, or else Christ be not so unto me. And as I am a true lady, I'll never marry none but thee. She sent in for her father the Duke, in all the speed that e'er might be. Put off my wedding, father, she said, for the love of God, this month's free. Sick I am, the lady said, oh, sick and very like to die. Put off my wedding, father, Duke, for the love of God, this month's free. The Duke of France put off this wedding of the steward and the lady months three. For the lady sick she was, sick, sick and like to die. She wrote a letter with her own hand in all the speed that ever might be. She sent it over into Scotland, that is so far beyond the sea. When the messenger came to the old Lord of Lorn, he kneeled low down on his knee. And he delivered the letter to him in all the speed that ever might be. First look he looked at the letter upon, lo, he wept full bitterly. The second look he looked at it upon, said, false steward, woe be to thee. When the lady of Lorn these tidings heard, O Lord, she wept so bitterly. I told you of this, now good my lord, when I sent my child into that wild country. Peace, lady of Lorn, the Lord did say, for Christ his love, I do pray thee. And as I am a Christian man, roken upon him that I will be. Wrote a letter with his own hand in all the speed that e'er might be. He sent it unto the lords in Scotland that were born of a great degree. He sent for lords, he sent for knights, the best that were in his country, to go with him into the land of France, to seek his son in that strange country. The wind was good and they did sail 500 men into France land. there to seek that bonny boy that was the worthy Lord of Lorn. They sought the country through and through, so far to the Duke's place of France land. There they were aware of that bonny boy, standing with a porter's staff in his hand. Then the worshipful they did bow, the serving men fell upon their knee. They cast their hats up into the air, for joy that boy that they had seen. The Lord of Lorn then he lighted down and kissed his child both cheek and chin, and said, God bless thee, my son and my heir, the bliss of heaven that thou may win. The false steward and the Duke of France were in a castle top truly. What fools are yon, says the false steward, to the porter make so low curtsy. Then bespake the Duke of France, calling my Lord of Lorn truly. He said, I doubt the day be come that either you or I must deem. They said the castle round about, a swallow could not have flown away. And there they took the false steward that the Lord of Lorn did betray. And when they had taken the false steward, he fell down low upon his knee, and craved mercy of the Lord of Lorn for the villainous deed he had done truly. Thou shalt have mercy, said the Lord of Lorn, thou vile traitor, I tell to thee, as the laws of the realm they will thee bear, whether it be for thee to live or die. A quest of lords that there was chosen to go upon his death truly. There they judged the false steward whether he was guilty and for the deed. The foreman of the jury he came in, he spake his words full loud and he said, make thee ready, thou false steward, for now thy death it draws full knee. Said he, if my death it draws full knee, God forgive me all I have done amiss. Where's that lady I've loved so long, before my death to give me a kiss? Away, thou traitor, the lady said, avoid out of my company. For thy vile treason thou hast wrought, thou need to cry to God for mercy. First they took him and hanged him half, and let him down before he was dead, and quartered him in quarters many, and sod him in a boiling lead. And then they took him out again, and cutten all his joints in sunder, and burned him eke upon a hill, I wis they did him cursedly cumber. A loud laughter the lady laughed, O Lord, she smiled merrily. She said, I may praise my heavenly king that ever I seen this vile traitor deed. Then bespake the Duke of France unto the right Lord of Lorn, said he there. Says, Lord of Lorn, if thou marry my daughter, I'll mend thy living 500 a year. Then bespake that bonny boy, and answered the Duke quickly, I'd rather marry your daughter with a ring of gold than all the gold that e'er I blinked on with mine e'e. But then bespake the old Lord of Lorn to the Duke of France, thus he did say, seeing our children do so well agree, they shall be married ere we go away. The Lady of Lorn she was sent for throughout Scotland so speedily, to see these two children set up in their seats of gold full royally. Let rebels therefore warned be how mischief once they do pretend, for God may suffer for a time, but will disclose it in the end.